What is good, guys? We're here with this tournament. I think it's like called Rigid Tour or something. And it's, yeah, between Rob, aka PokerTG Gamer, and Drampage. And this man basically wanted me to record because, like, they knew each other and then they are in our Discord chat. And I don't know if Dennis picked up the call yet or he didn't. Well, that sucks. I guess I'll call again. Hi?
Hello.
Can you see the game on SmogTours?
Okay, I just logged into SmogTours.
Because yeah, this is, I think Drampage brought this in Draco Premier League versus the Dirt. But I don't really remember any sets.
Wait, where can I connect to SmogTours? What's going on?
I'll just send you the link, I guess. Yeah, so this is probably... Is this a Scarf Greninja or Scarf Lari?
Okay, I can see now. Thank
so
you.
I would definitely scout for the Scarf... for Ice Beam in general here. Even
yeah.
If it's not Scarf, without Speed.
So I would go like...
Keldeo,
probably, yeah.
So if it's Spikes Greninja, I would Spike here.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, Ice Beam. No item, so
yeah, I think he's Scarf. My expert belt, but Scarf makes more sense because he likes to use
so
that set.
Keldeo could go for secret sword.
I mean, the Lari is so obvious.
Lari. Yeah.
I probably double into
But what double does
into Heatran?
Rampage, yeah.
But Heatran is kind of risky with a dog in the back.
Yeah, that's true. Yeah, I think
I mean, the Lari is so obvious.
Double into Greninja.
Oh yeah, that's a good one.
So yeah, because it covered the Ice Beam as well. Yeah.
So this is Heatran Greninja? Okay, it's Ash.
No, Ash Greninja.
So if he... I don't know if he's gonna scum and go for the flinch here.
I wouldn't risk that, because...
I assume the Ferrozone is gonna go for Hazard.
Yeah.
Because he might try
If he's, if he's confident that Ferrozone is gonna separate the other...
Yeah, that's what I want to say.
Mm-hmm.
That he might go for a Leech Seed, he might try to predict the Leech Seed and go superior.
No, Power Whip was a good play because looking at Pocket TCG Gamer, I think Ash Greninja is actually a big threat.
Yeah, he didn't want to mess around with
his
threat.
His only resist is like his own Greninja.
So this can go for Leaf Storm.
Yeah,
or do you think it's T-Way
Feral?
Okay, it's not T-Way Feral, then if he switches.
Dodge.
I mean, they wouldn't have done too much.
Nah. Do you think Latios is Scarf? Scarf default or something?
Oh, I think it's Z-move. It could be Z-move Doggy too.
Mm-hmm.
Oh, I expect Latios is an option. Because I've seen him use that. I'm just going off what they've used so far. Oh yeah, I was watching Jammed like 10 minutes ago, guys. And I was like about to fall asleep. Because I didn't sleep much last night. Was up on that young grind. TDK was Gypsy King was like 4 a.m. And I just showed BDB that recording because he wanted to see it, and like my narration's kind of weird in that one. But yeah, he misses a Draco. So if that was Specs, that would have done like 40% maybe.
Yeah, that's Specs.
See, yeah.
Mhm. Ooh.
Okay, dodge does some justice.
Okay.
I mean,
so
you can go Greninja maybe.
So it's like Specs with Trick, I'm assuming.
Yeah, like I think he's gonna go for Rocks here on the Greninja.
Yeah, I would go Hard Greninja. Orlando,
maybe.
The rocks. Ooh, Double Storm, that was a good play.
I mean, yeah, Storm makes sense too, because like
cause
Greninja
wasn't
really switching.
Yeah, it was pretty risk free actually, but yeah. Hazards would have been...
I'm not sure if this is offensive rocks, Orlando. I'm not really trying to calc at the moment. Because I think Magma Storm would do a little bit more to...
Yeah, I think it's defensive, Orlando.
I think it has some sort of HP investment at least, yeah.
Judging by the damage, I don't know. I didn't calc either, but...
Yeah, like...
I'm assuming if it was offensive, it would have done at least like 60 or more. I don't know.
Went for Fly.
Fly, so is it like bulk up?
He is probably Z-move.
Yeah, Z move superpower maybe. Although pummeling or Z fly.
Maybe mixed.
Mm-hmm.
Oh, not Rocky Helmet, so that could have been Starfrog Z move Lander.
Okay.
I assume it would still have HP Ice.
I don't think. Do you think he's gonna go for Ice Beam again?
I'd you turn here?
I don't know. Yeah. I wouldn't go for Ice Beam again, like.
But he might know how he plays and stay in.
Yeah. He went for Kelly again.
I mean, U-turn is kind of obvious.
Yeah, U-turn. Mm-hmm. That's. Like, it's easy to say, like,
so one Lottie, of the Lottie pretty much gets a kill with Draco.
Yup.
Because after rocks, Heaton cannot take two. Damn, this music is fire. Why don't I listen to this more often?
Well, I don't know if there was a misplay, but like.
Oh, maybe he maybe. I don't know. Maybe he should meant he should have stayed in and read that? I don't know.
Yeah.
Yeah, he. I mean,
he acknowledges that, at least.
I mean, that's not really a misplay, that's like...
Nah.
An aggressive...
I guess he played... Yeah, he played, like, maybe too safe, but, like, it's not a misplay.
He just says that in the chat so he gets some attention on YouTube. That boy wants to have some screen time.
Yeah, so just... He doesn't have...
I mean, he's going for the dodge, yeah, with whatever he's switching in, Heatran or... Yeah, Heatran. Oh, what? Scarf Kelly Scarf. With Icy Wind? Oh, did he...
Okay, Kelly is dead, though.
Okay, so now he can go Greninja and get his Ash form. Because I don't think Ferrothorn can switch in. Maybe Ferrothorn... Yeah, Ferrothorn can barely lift too, but it's... How much did the first Dark Pulse do? I'm just looking it up. It did 40%. So I don't think Ferrothorn can come.
Poke TCG Gamers Greninja is more threatening now that he lost this Scarf Keldeo, I think. Because it was a good way to
repair. Yeah.
Ooh, Z-fly.
I mean, that's definitely gonna get a kill here. He didn't have any switch-ins, and the Lottie was at minus 2. Yeah, he can. Yeah, T-Wave,
Why didn't he go Ash Greninja? Could Ferrothorn have lived two Dark Pulses?
No, the 40 the first time, I don't think he could have lived two.
Yeah, oh, okay, I guess he wanted to.
So, like, T-Wave being nerfed is kind of big, because, like, otherwise Thundurus can go for Prankster T-Wave versus Greninja.
Yeah.
I mean, they don't really run
T-Wave that often. Some kind of Defiant set with, I don't know.
Oh, I don't think I would have gone for Ice Beam, but He predicted him to stay in this time on a U-turn, because last time he switched and it worked out, and he didn't want to make the aggressive play again. He was trying to make the read there, but it didn't work out.
I don't know. Judging from the turns I've seen so far, he hasn't made any kind of like aggressive play.
I think I would have U-turned again.
Nice trap.
Yeah, I mean, he had to sex something there because the Greninja was locked in the Ice Beam. Yeah, he turned gets trapped. Arena trap says, hi, I'm broken. So you can go Greninja or...
Greninja,
you can also go into...
Zygarde, I guess.
Superior.
Yeah. Thundurus is not switching because it takes rocks and Dagi can have stolen.
Superior kind of wins. Actually, no, it gets outsped by Dagi, what am I saying? It gets outsped by Dagi, and then it probably gets put in range from Greninja, yeah.
And Medicham can go for Fake Out too.
So, if he's Dragon and Zygarde... Mm-hmm. Actually, he already showed Z-move Thundurus. Because I only see Dragon and Zygarde with Z-move, I don't really see it otherwise.
Yeah, with Dragonium Z.
Yeah, so I think it's Bandit then.
Yeah, I think the play is either Serp or Greninja. Okay.
I mean, Serp should get a kill for sure.
Yup. I mean, at this point, you suck Dagi.
Wait,
I think
did he show his Z move yet? If this is
No, Poke TCG Gaming didn't go for any Z move.
I'm pretty sure he was Z move on Landorus.
Hmm.
Because like he likes to use Landorus with like rocks and Z move.
Dagi is actually pretty useless now.
Because if he's like for some reason Supersonic Sky Strike target, it would be nice, but I don't think he is. Oh, what the fuck? Okay.
Wait, that is some good damage, I guess, for being resisted.
Yeah, I mean, Zemos are broken, so of course it is.
Okay, and now Greninja is the Ice Beam.
Yeah, he's just U-turning.
Yeah.
Because it's a risk-free play, and
exactly, either gets the kill out of momentum. And gets momentum.
See? I thought it was some bullshit flying him, that's what I was thinking too when I saw the Z-move activate. Yeah, okay, Ice Beam was fine too, but it lets the Greninja come in here. So Greninja can click Dark Bolts here, or Hydro Pump. Yeah, he can click Hydro Pump here.
Mm-hmm.
Then he gets the Ash Form and he should just win. I don't think if he could, I don't know if he could have prevented that. Like if he U-turned out into Medicham.
I think the one of the play that put Drampage in a very good position early on was the double Magma Storm that caught the Lando T.
I mean, Rob seems like offensive, and he didn't really have good switch into Magma Storm. Like, so that was a fine play, yeah.
Mm-hmm.
Even if he U-turned and killed the...
Yeah, I don't think he could have won at that point. Because Drampage is more sex anyway, fake out.
Yeah, I had a scenario in my head, but I forgot it now. I had it calculated.
And now, not even a second fake out takes it out, so yeah. This is GG.
Wait, is he? Yeah, he's Ash, so he's gonna get his Ash form here. I think he's gonna try to go into his own Greninja here, because he doesn't want to give him the form change.
I mean, yeah, that's like his only play.
Yeah, but then he's in E-Speed range, probably, if he takes damage.
Yep. Yeah, that's checkmate. And like, it doesn't matter what he does. Like.
Yeah, if he's not in E-Speed range, he's in E-Speed plus Water Shuriken range.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah, so of course Drambage asked to record... that I record this so he can shine and beat Rob the God just on the YouTube.
Okay, so...
Yeah, Porsche's playing in like 3 hours. I hope I can still narrate this. I might fall asleep.
Oh yeah, timer wasn't even on. I was about to say, I don't know why they're taking
so. They're like friends and they played fast anyway. But now this guy said, I'm taking the win. Move, noob. Like, he can think 10 minutes about this. I don't think he has an out.
No. Yeah, he went Greninja, but like... Yeah, that's E-Speed range, I'm pretty sure.
I mean, Mineral might not kill, but then it's in Shuriken range, like I said, yeah.
Okay, just to be... Just out of curiosity.
What is this plane at the end of his name that he puts, just so people can see the replay? Or maybe it's just for aesthetic?
Yeah, Adamant Choice Band E-Speed does actually 58 minimum. So
oh, minimum. I thought it would be minimum 52.
Nah, 58 is minimum, if adamant.
I mean, sometimes I just run head calcs when I'm too lazy to calc.
Yeah, so it was game either way. Yeah, suck Flanders because it's useless. U-turn. Okay.
Yeah, so it's gonna click fake out and it's gonna...
Fake out kills, right?
Yeah, it kills, but you can also go Zyga to preserve the 3-0.
Yeah, that's actually true, if you really wanted to. He could have swept with
I mean, it was unnecessary because he could Ice Punch and Zyga wins the game, so there's no point in making that play.
Like unnecessary and kind of...
I mean, he probably still won Water Shuriken.
Not scammy move, but like, what's the point? Water Shuriken. That doesn't kill.
This might even kill. Oh, no, man.
Nah, it doesn't kill. But E-Speed does.
Like, Ash Ranger is like strong as fuck.
Okay, now he killed. Yeah, 2-0. GG.
No freeze. So lucky. See, this is just the best of one, so there's no other game, and Drampage picks up the win. I can show you guys the thread here. It's kind of funny, because I don't know if Vertex did this on purpose, like he's hosting this tournament, I think, and he put Sadurz versus Heilbronner, and they know each other, and he put Drampage versus PokéTCG Gamer. Like, I don't know. There are like some interesting games. I won't record many. Oh, whoa, he put iPro versus King K-Dot. They're also both in our chat, so I might try to record that if I'm really able to.
Wait, iPro is in our chat too?
Yeah, he doesn't really talk much. I'm just scrolling through the matchups. I know that Ray Scarfis versus BKC is like a big one. Oh, Super versus Royster Pro. Like, that's Eric. Eric got onto World Cup. Congrats to Eric. He's a sub for Canada.
Canada, yup.
Yeah, this other guy is...
BKC versus Ray Scarfis is actually a pretty big one.
Yeah, this Royster Pro guy, he was an OEPL. And this poor guy got like tossed by Baton Pass like a few hours before Baton Pass got banned. Like, I recorded the game, but I didn't upload it yet, because like I was eating and I would have to re-narrate it. I might actually do that, because it's pretty funny, because it shows how stupid Baton Pass is. Literally, Majuna got speed passed, got a call made up, and then just 6-0'd. And then I was like thinking, man, Baton Pass is stupid. And like 3 hours later, the thread goes up, Baton Pass is now banned.
Yeah.
Nice. Yeah.
But nah, Baton Pass wasn't broken, right? Like, come on.
Young Velocify. Let me scroll. What do you have? Yeah, there's like a lot of people. I don't know all of them. But this is just more for fun, and I record this because he asked me. And my main focus will be on the World Cup qualifier games. Definitely BTB versus TL6 should be happening around weekend. And Uzigana versus Alcan should be happening on Saturday. What else? Yeah, we have 2 Smokter series today because Alexander. When he was available yesterday, Bengay was not available, and Bengay was like, I think he could only play at 2 a.m. And Alexander didn't want to play 2 a.m, so they might probably play today, or will probably have to play today, because I don't think they will get an extension longer than today. And yeah, I know that Porsche is in 2 hours and 40 minutes or something like that, and I already got my Spanish beat ready, so that's gonna be fun. And yeah, we got young Dennis the Goat in the video. And we out. And yeah, nice win, Drampage noob. Okay, I'm just trolling you.
Congrats.
I mean, I don't know how I feel about that team. Like, that was just a super offensive team. Like, he might be comfortable with this team, but I would never use a team like this. Like, Latios, Ductrio, Landris, Ferrothorn, Medicham, Greninja. Like, you don't really have switch-ins to anything. Like,
yeah, I guess, like, you have to feel pretty confident to
it's
bring
it's personal
sort of
preference. I just
to a tournament, like, yeah, I get your point of view. Like, you want to have some sort of switch-ins to stuff.
Like, I either use bulky offense or balance. I don't really know, but yeah, Drampage seems like it had like a little bit. Better checks in the sense that, like, Scarf Kelly is pretty much. Like, Scarf Kelly put in so much work. Like, the only answer or switching for Kelly was, like, Latios. And, like, we all know Zygarde is broken, just like 1,000 arrows. yeah, I don't know why I'm still trying to analyze this. Like, when I'm tired, I just never end my recordings, I just keep talking forever, but yeah. Kind of interesting match, and peace out, Bob.
Bob, bye.